Recentemente sono rimasto sorpreso da due notizie. La prima riguarda Volvo, che ha annunciato che dal 2019...
Recently, I was surprised by two things. The first concerns Volvo, who announced that from 2019, all of its new cars will have an electric motor. The other is even more revolutionary. Cantieri Del Pardo has built a motorboat. They thought about it for a long time before it was built, 44 years. And to make sure they didn't make any mistakes, they first built 4,000 of them, with sails. Cantieri Del Pardo has been producing sailing yachts since 1973. Obviously, they are used to building high-level boats. They wanted to present themselves as best in the motor segment too. This is Pardo 43. It is obviously a boat used to sunbathe and go to have a swim. For the swim platform, you can choose between two sizes. The longer one is submersible and serves several purposes: to launch and recover the tender or as a sunbathing area. The bow should belong to the list of technical characteristics, but look at it, it is inverted, and I prefer to consider it from an aesthetic point of view. If you spend a whole day on board, you will discover the usefulness of having a convertible living area in different situations: living room, dining area, solarium. And with the movable backrests, you can sit in the direction you prefer. Those corridors, I would rather they have a door closing towards the stern. The kitchen is sheltered by the T-top and can be hidden by a glass cover. If you have used it, but you did not want to clean it right away, here everything is very elegant, but the glossy black color is difficult to keep perfectly clean. It is customizable, however, and you can choose other colors, less complicated ones. Now let's go below deck. As it is not completely continuous, the ceiling is lowered along the perimeter around the bed, but there is no bother at all. This place is very airy, thanks to its brightness, and also the fact that they use the bulkheads only to isolate the bathroom. The rest is an open space. There is only one cabin, with a double berth towards the bow and two singles under the cockpit.
Al progetto ha contribuito naturalmente il cantiere e anche...
The shipyard naturally contributed to the design, as well as an experienced Italian studio, the Zuccheri Yacht Design. The concept is absolutely modern, current, a sporty open, very comfortable.
Le murate sono alte anche a prua.
The sides are also high at the bow, so you can move anywhere safely, because this yacht wants to make everyone feel at ease, even those who are not used to sailing. Pardo 43 is 13.45 meters long, though if you prefer the longer submersible swim platform, it reaches 14 meters.
La larghezza è di 4,20 m.
It is 4.2 meters wide and weighs just 10 tons, because it is built by vacuum-infused resin.
Lo scafo è laminato a pieno, mentre le murate...
The hull is fully laminated, while the sides are built in sandwich. Two layers of fiberglass, and in the middle, one of PVC. So it is lighter and equally solid.
La carena ha un angolo a V di circa...
The hull has a V angle of about 16 degrees at the transom, but towards the bow it is even sharper, even more narrow.
Poco prima del dritto,
just before the stem, angle is more than 50 degrees between the hull and the surface of the water.
Nel frattempo, l'abbiamo portata...
In the meantime, we have begun planing at a speed of 12 knots. The engines are at 1,880 revolutions per minute. The consumption right now is 3.3 liters for each mile of navigation. Let's note this data.
questo tipo di yacht potrebbe essere scelto dopo le prime esperienze di navigazione, magari con una.
This type of yacht could be chosen by beginners who perhaps only have experience with a small boat or a dinghy. But is it difficult to maneuver? No, there is a joystick because the engines are Volvo Penta, rated at 370 horsepower. And the IPS propulsion, the one with the counter-rotating forward-facing propellers under the hull, which are very efficient and easy, in fact, any berth, any mooring.
Mano a mano che la velocità cresce, possiamo fare a meno degli interceptor. Una sorta di.
As the speed increases, we can do without interceptors. A sort of flap that is applied on the transom. They are used to adjust the boat's ascent, so let's raise them slightly, thus decreasing the hydrodynamic resistance. We have reached 18 knots and the consumption is still the same, 3.3 litres for every mile of navigation. We're going faster, but our consumption is the same.
Questo modello è un po' più pesante di quello standard perché hanno installato la.
This model is a bit heavier than the standard because they have installed the larger submersible plank aft. So there are all the electrohydraulic mechanisms. There is a gyro stabilizer, the generator. In short, maybe there will be 1,500 kilos more, and speeds could therefore be slightly lower than those of a less equipped model. The T-top is carbon, so it does not raise the center of gravity. We just have to worry about the action of the wind.
Il mare sembra una tavola, sembra privo di onde. In realtà, però, c'è un'onda lunga di mare morto.
The sea is flat. It seems like there are no waves, but in reality, there is a long wave of dead sea that gently accompanies our navigation. But the hull is very docile. Have you seen how it leans softly on the water? It does it right where the hull is deeper, and that's why the waves are always cut gently.
Voglio darvi un dato di navigazione interessante per il diportista.
I want to give you some interesting cruising data. 25 knots, engines at 2,880 RPM. Here you can take off some more of the flap.
La velocità cresce leggermente.
The speed increases slightly. We have earned half a knot without giving gas, and consumption is now 4 liters per mile of navigation.
Le barche con questo tipo di carena mi piacciono da un punto di vista.
I like boats with this type of hull from an aesthetic point of view, but from a dynamic point of view, I like them only if, as in this case, they keep the bow a bit raised, a bit out of the water.
In questa maniera le virate sono.
This way the turns are much safer. In fact, I must tell you that it is really nice to act on the rudder and feel how it responds.
Togliamo completamente gli interceptor e l'assetto cambia.
We completely remove the interceptors and the set changes decidedly. The boat is raised even more at the bow. Now on this long wave began to delineate, but it is still very pleasant.
Abbiamo raggiunto il massimo.
We have reached the engine's maximum speed and we are traveling at 36 knots.
Ora, visti i risultati di questo test, mi chiedo.
Now, given the results of this test, I wonder why they have waited so long to build a motorboat. They couldn't have done it sooner.